Our nose uses quantum physics to smell, at least according to our best theory of how smell works. Now, how our noses work was always a bit of a mystery to me, but I recently learned how they worked, and so I thought I'd make a video about it. When you sniff, odour molecules get sucked into your nose and then get captured by a layer of mucus and are then taken to a postage stamp sized area in the top of your nasal cavity called the olfactory epithelium. This contains bundles of neurons containing special receptor sites which detect the molecules and send signals to the brain. It has been difficult to know exactly how receptors work because nobody has worked out a way of looking at them while they're in a living nose. You can take them out of a nose and look at them, but then they lose their structure when they're not supported by the cell membrane that they sit in. It would be like taking a jellyfish out of the sea, which just collapses into a mush. We know that the sensation of smell is caused by odour molecules being caught by the receptor sites, which then causes those neurons to fire. But because we can't directly look at the receptors, we have to infer how they work from indirect evidence. Now there's two main theories about how smell receptors work, shape and vibration. The shape theory says that the smell receptors have specific shapes that fit the odour molecules, kind of like a key fitting into a lock. However, this theory doesn't quite work because we know that we don't have one kind of receptor for every type of odour molecule. We have about 300 different kinds of receptors, but we can detect about 10,000 different smells, so there's something more complicated going on. The latest theory is that each receptor is built to fit just one section of a molecule, so any molecule that has that part will have a similar smell. So any molecule that has a sulfur-hydrogen bond will smell like rotten eggs. This matches with the evidence because you can get many different shaped molecules that end up having the same smell because they've got a similar molecular group. However, this theory can't explain everything. There's certain molecules that are made of the exact same groups, but are just arranged in a different way. But they smell very different to each other. For example, vanillin, which smells like vanilla, has all the same molecular groups, just in a different order to isovanillin, which is a very nasty, sickly medicinal smell. So there's an alternative theory of smell receptors, the vibration theory. In the vibration model of smell, the smell receptor can tell the difference between different molecules based on how they vibrate. Each chemical bond has a certain resonant frequency that it naturally vibrates at, kind of like how an open guitar string always resonates at the same frequency and so always gives you the same pitch. So different molecules have a different signature set of vibrational frequency, which depends on what atoms they're made of and how they're all connected. In the past, scientists have harnessed this property to figure out the chemical composition of molecules using light in a process called Raman spectroscopy. When you shine laser light through a bunch of molecules, some of the light's absorbed to make these molecular bonds vibrate, and then light with different energy, and hence a different frequency, is emitted. You can then look at the frequencies of this new light, which we see as their colour, and work out what the molecules are made of. And it's worth mentioning that when it comes to light, each specific colour relates to a specific frequency, which has a specific energy. There's a one-to-one mapping between them. This has been a great way to detect different kinds of molecule. So perhaps our smell receptors are doing something like this. But for many years, the vibration theory of smell was not very popular because there's no way our noses can do Raman spectroscopy as, unfortunately, our noses don't emit laser beams and we can't be using natural light because we can smell in the dark. But there is another method to detect the vibrations of molecules that uses electrons instead of light, which comes from the realm of quantum physics. It's a form of quantum tunneling. Quantum tunneling is the phenomena where quantum particles, like electrons, can travel to places that normal classical particles can't. They can jump through walls by disappearing from one side and immediately appearing on the other. This is one of the counterintuitive behaviours of quantum particles and is a consequence of quantum particles behaving as spread out waves. In a specific situation, electron tunneling can actually be used to find the resonant frequencies of molecules. If we take two metals and separate them by a small barrier, and then apply a voltage to make an electron get pushed to one side. Normally, in classical physics, the electron can't get across this barrier, but if the gap is very small, it can quantum tunnel to the other side. But there's an additional condition. An electron in a metal has a certain energy, and it can only tunnel to the other side if there's an empty hole which has got the same energy. But if the hole on the other side is at a lower energy, the electron can't tunnel because there's nowhere for the spare energy to go. But if we introduce a molecule into the gap, something interesting happens. If the energy difference between the electron and the hole is just the same as the energy needed to vibrate one of the resonances of the molecule, then the electron is allowed to tunnel across and it drops its extra energy into vibrating the molecule when it goes across. Scientists have built machines that use this property to probe molecules. The technique is called inelastic electron tunneling spectroscopy. You can put in different molecules, change the energy difference between the electron and the hole, and see where the electron tunnels, which tells you about the resonances of the molecule, and so tells you what it's made from. So perhaps our nose is doing the same thing. Perhaps our smell receptors are behaving like that metal and the gap, which is waiting for an odour molecule to come in, which allows an electron to pass across the receptor and trigger the nerve. To find out, scientists did some very clever experiments. This theory makes a very specific prediction that the odour of a molecule depends on the frequencies it vibrates at. So if you could change the frequencies of a molecule, you would also change its smell. So that's exactly what they did. They took a molecule, but replaced all of the hydrogen atoms with a heavier form of hydrogen called deuterium, which instead of having one proton in the nucleus, they've got a proton and a neutron. Deuterium has all the same chemical properties as hydrogen, but is much heavier. The scientists got a bunch of the normal molecules and the heavier deuterated molecules, and got different subjects to sniff them to see if they could tell the difference. Humans, fruit flies, and whitefish. They found strong evidence from these creatures that these two different forms of the molecule actually smelled different. This is really cool because it's really good evidence that our noses use quantum physics to smell the world, which I find utterly amazing. Quantum physics shouldn't play much of a role in our warm, complicated bodies, so it's crazy that it does. But as successful as the vibration model is, it can't explain everything. You may have heard of chiral molecules, which are molecules that are made of all the same stuff but arranged as mirror images of each other. For example, carbone has a left-handed and right-handed form. Because these are made of the same atoms and bonds, they have all the same vibrations, so will look identical to vibration tests like Raman spectroscopy and inelastic electron tunneling. So according to the vibration theory, they should smell the same, but they don't. One form smells like caraway or dill, and the other smells like spearmint. So what can we conclude from all of this? It seems like you need both the shape model and the vibration model to explain how we smell. Perhaps our receptors first check the shape of the molecules, and then if they get past that barrier, they are checked for their resonance vibrations through quantum tunneling. But we won't know exactly how this works until we can figure out a way of directly observing the receptor sites in action. But isn't it crazy to think that these experiences of smell we have of a flower or coffee or freshly baked bread or a newborn baby, this experience of the world came to your brain through something as strange as quantum tunneling. So quantum physics, which seems for many people to be so strange and abstract, well, it's going on right up your nose. Just like all my other videos, I've made a poster for this one. You can either buy it or get it for free. Check in the description to see where to get those. Also, if I've made any mistakes in this video, which does happen, I put that in the description too. So if you spot anything, check there. And if it's not there, then leave a comment and I'll address that. Other than that, I'm going to be making a ton more videos now under the banner of Domain of Science. So I'll see you on the next one.